वेद, आई एम द वन हु हैज गिवन द वेदांता, आई हैव कंपाइल्ड वेदांता, एंड देयरफॉर आई हैव टू बी सीन एज द मेंटेनर. गतिर भर्ता प्रभु साक्षी निवास शरणम सुरित निवास, आई एम द शेल्टर गिवर, आई एम द ओके. शरणम इज शेल्टर गिवर. What could निवास mean? Somewhere where you rest in or inhabit.
Yeah, so it's not just a shelter giver, but also the shelter. I think that,
Okay, yeah. In that sense. So in that sense, a follower of Bhagavad Gita would put Krishna as the founder of this understanding of Sanatan Dharma.
yes, that's true. So now, you want to put Krishna as the founder, then that brings the question, then when Prabhupada said he's the founder Acharya, what exactly does that mean then?
In that sense, an Acharya has three broad connotations. The simplest level or the basic level, Acharya is a Sanskrit teacher. They are always called Acharya of Acharya. Sanskrit in the sense Vedic culture, which is coded in Sanskrit language, somebody who has an ashram, somebody who teaches students, very basic level. Second level Acharya is somebody who follows a particular system of Vedic tradition, and there are many of such acharyas. There could be many. And a founder acharya or a sansthapak acharya is a very high post where somebody has suggested, enacted, or emphasized upon following a particular set of codes as long as that institution exists. So that's the third understanding of Prabhupada as a founder acharya. Is a very, very precisely clear and a very important one. It's a very exalted post. So he's not just a teacher. He didn't just teach his followers to chant, dance, cook, or perform deity worship. He was not simply somebody who presided over establishment of temples. He was someone who kind of translated ancient codes or ancient rules and regulations to fit the modern milieu, the modern environment, and insisted that this is how things should be done as long as this institution exists. So that's why he's called the preeminent instructing teacher.